With five speakers, you have them on the program. We initially had six speakers, we are down to five. We have Luis Riera Figueres, Gabriel Zimmer, Cecilia Alemani, Dan Cunha, and Noriyuki Suzuki. We have apologies from Anders Pedersen of SIDA, who is not able to be with us. He has other commitments. And SIDA wishes to assure us that this is not any sign of lack of commitment to our proceedings. And in fact, we do have a representative from SIDA for the next panel discussion. So I will briefly introduce each speaker in the order that you have them on the program. And then
said at the very beginning, what is the place of decent work in the European European Commission and the European Union development policy? God said decent work is everywhere in policy terms, and I think it is. I mean, let me recollect that in 2006 we proposed a communication to the Council on decent work, and that we further explored the issue in the area of developing countries with what we call a staff working document, working paper on promotion of employment on developing countries in 2007. Frankly speaking, the Council asked us at that moment to pursue this work in working further in one of the key pillars of the decent work agenda, with of course social protection. And we frankly thought, and I prefer
to eradicate poverty, children poverty, and in the European Union or in Europe, if we don't have a look, a view also to the situation in the development countries. If we don't fight for decent work in the development countries, we can't realize the concept of good work in the European Union. I'm sure of this, and I'm also sure we can't eradicate poverty, children poverty, social exclusion in the European Union if we don't change the role as of the European Union as a global actor. If you look to one example, in the last week in the mini plenary session in Brussels, the European Parliament decided about the declaration concerning.
Estamos en un momento de crisis del sistema. Estamos ante una crisis sistémica que combina, sí, una crisis financiera y una recesión económica profunda, pero también la crisis del precio de los alimentos, del cambio climático y demás. Es una combinación de crisis que para América Latina no es nueva. Llevamos 3-4 décadas viviéndola cada 10 años, pero se hizo global del momento que pegó a las economías centrales, a Estados Unidos y Europa. Ahora, decididamente, la crisis del sistema está globalizada. Y de alguna forma esto es una crisis del modelo de desarrollo. Y por eso creo que esta conferencia hoy es mucho, muy oportuna, no solo porque coloca el tema de la construcción de un modelo de desarrollo alternativo, sino porque pone a la justicia social y al trabajo decente en el centro. Y creo que esta es la agenda, no solo de los sindicatos, también de todos los demás movimientos sociales a nivel mundial. Hoy en día estamos ante una crisis del modelo que, si miramos los compromisos internacionales que COS
desarrolló. El work concept, o el decent work agenda, comprises of four main elements. And that's employment creation, that's social protection and social dialogue, fundamental workers' rights and international standards. And with time, these four components have become also the four strategic objectives of the ILO, and they are still the four strategic objectives of the ILO. Now, I will just digress a little just to respond to what Mr. Michel said in the morning, in order not to leave any misunderstanding. He said that countries are not putting forward requests on decent work. But all these programs of the EU are for me on decent work. They are on the components of decent work. All these programs on child labor, on forced labor, on migration, on employment, on that.
My answer is the trade union is a democracy itself. What we are doing in our daily activity is to build a social infrastructure in our societies that is a mechanism for the distributive justice. I think this is the only one answer to your question. The distributive justice is lacking in a region in terms of the working conditions, wages, employment, and gender equality. We do not have a proper strong social safety net, and we do not have a proper fair taxation and fiscal policy. So building strong the